ओम श्री साई राम। डियर चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू पार्ट टू ऑफ एलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशंस एंड पॉलिनोमियल्स। लास्ट टाइम वी हैड डिस्कस्ड वेरिएबल्स एंड कॉन्स्टेंट्स, एलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशंस एंड देयर टर्म्स, polynomials and its types, like and unlike polynomials. If you remember, variables and constants, I shared with you the example of a moving train. When you are observing the moving train standing on the ground, you can identify what are the things that are moving and what things are stationary. So correlated in mathematics, variables are those things which can have different values. In an algebraic expression, the value of variables will change, whereas the constants will remain same in a particular algebraic expression. Then we discussed what are algebraic expressions and their terms. If you recall, algebraic expression will be a combination or is a combination of symbols and numbers connected using mathematical operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. These are the four mathematical operations that we will be discussing at this level. Then the next thing that we discussed was polynomials as a special type of algebraic expressions. When does an algebraic expression become a polynomial? So if you recall, there were three conditions for it. The first condition was that no variable should be in the denominator. Second condition, that the power or the exponent of the variable should be a whole number. And the third condition was that the coefficient of the variable should be a real number. Then we discuss the types of polynomials on the basis of terms. If a polynomial has got only one term, it is called a monomial. If it has got two terms, it is called a binomial. And if it has got three terms, then it is called a trinomial. We also learnt to identify like and unlike terms in a polynomial. So like terms are those which have same variables. So those terms which have same variable. For example, if first term is 2x square y and third term is also 5x square y. So x square y is same in both the terms. So these are two like terms in the given polynomial. There was one home assignment given. We will quickly go through this assignment. In the first question, which of the following expressions are polynomials in one variable and which are not? And you also have to state the reason for your answer. I hope each one of you has attempted it. Let's see whether we are on the same page or not. If you look at the first part, how many variables are there? Variables are just symbols. So how many symbols are there? It is x. Symbol x, exponent is changing here. In this first term, exponent is 2. In the second term, exponent is 1. But variable remains same. So variable here is only 1. And what is that variable? It is x. And I hope the reason for it is clear, because x is the only variable which is occurring in this given polynomial. Look at the second one. Variable is z out here. Again, only one variable, though the exponent of z here is 2. And how many terms are there in this variable? How many terms are there in this algebraic expression? There are 2 terms in this algebraic expression. This is first one and this is the second one. Let us look at the third one. Here it is y raised to the power half. Under root y means y raised to the power half plus y root 3. We have to identify the variables. First of all, is it a polynomial or not? It is an algebraic expression, but is this algebraic expression a polynomial? That is the first thing we need to check. And after identifying that, then only we will look at the variables. So if you see here, the second condition that the exponent of the variable should be a whole number is not satisfied here. Hence, this third part is not a polynomial. It is an algebraic expression. And what is the variable here? Variable is y. But you need to clearly understand this, that it is an algebraic expression in variable y, but it is not a polynomial. Let us look at the fourth part. In fourth part, it is t plus 2 upon t. So before going on to identify the variable in the polynomial, we need to first see whether it is a polynomial or not. Again, we observe that it is not a polynomial. And why is it not a polynomial? Because the variable is in the denominator. So it does not satisfy the first condition. It is an algebraic expression, and for this algebraic expression, the variable is t, but it is not a polynomial. Let us look at the fifth part. How many variables are there? There is only one variable, and that variable is y. So only one variable here. It has got 3 terms. I hope you will be able to write the reason correctly. Let us look at question number 2. Write the coefficient of x square in each of the following. First one, coefficient. I hope you remember. What is coefficient? Coefficient is a number before the variable. So which variable we have to see? We have to see x square. Now what is the coefficient of x square? If nothing is written out here, it means it is 1. So what is the coefficient of x square? Coefficient of x square is 1 here. Now what is the coefficient of x square in second part? This is the x square term. Coefficient of x square, what is prefix to x square? It is minus 3. Let us look at the third part. Coefficient of x square, so this is the term containing x square. Coefficient of x square is pi by 2. Fourth one, coefficient of x square. Can you see x square term here? No, there is no x square term here. So then what do we do? We can add the x square term here. If I write it 0 x square, your polynomial will remain same, 3x minus 1, because 0 multiplied by anything is 0. So what is the coefficient of x square here? Coefficient of x square is 0. We will not write down that it does not have x square term. when they are asking us the coefficient of x square, we need to write down the x square term and we will write the coefficient of x square as 0. Let us look at question number 3. Give the number of variables in the following polynomials. Variables. How many variables are here? X is one variable, y is another variable, and z is another variable. Now, how many times x or y is coming? That we do not have to see. We only have to see how many variables are there. So, there are 3 variables here. Second part, how many variables are there? U and v. So, there are 2 variables. So, in first one, x, y and z were the 3 variables. In second part, u and v are the 2 variables. So, they have asked us the number of variables. So, number of variables will be 3 in first part and 2 in the second part. So, I hope you had done this assignment. Before proceeding further, let me narrate a story to you. In a biology class, a teacher was explaining how a butterfly comes out. I hope you know that a butterfly comes from caterpillar. So the teacher told the students that in a couple of hours, the butterfly would emerge from the cocoon, and the instruction which was given was that don't touch it, don't try to help the butterfly come out. So the students were waiting and observing what is happening. The butterfly was struggling to get out of the cocoon. And against the advice of the teacher, one student took pity on this butterfly and helped the butterfly come out of the cocoon. So he broke the cocoon so that the butterfly could come out. And what happened? The butterfly did not struggle to come out. And after coming out, after some time, the butterfly died. Now, when the teacher returned to the class, everyone narrated what had happened. So, the teacher shared with the students the importance of struggle in life. Now, why did this butterfly not survive? Because it did not go through the struggle. The wings could strengthen only when they went through the struggle of coming out. Since this particular butterfly was deprived of that struggle, that is why it could not survive. The same is true in life. At this stage, you have to do a lot of hard work. Home assignments are given to you during online classes. Go through this struggle and do it yourself. Don't try to take help from here and there, because that will make your work easy. But you will not be going through that process of struggle which is mandatory for every student to pass. So whenever these home assignments are given, put in your mind and try to solve it. Don't find the easy way. easy way will save your time, but at the end, the road stops there. Let's come back to what we have to study today. We are going to discuss three topics today. One is degree of a polynomial, other is value of a polynomial, and third is zero of a polynomial. So let's first look at degree of a polynomial. When we are finding the degree of a polynomial, we should first learn to find the degree of each term in the given polynomial. So what is the degree of a term? Any polynomial is given to you. The sum of the exponents of the variables in a term is called the degree of the term. For example, if we have a term, say 5y cube plus 2y square plus 3xy. Now let us look at the degree of each term. First term is this. What is the exponent of the variable here? Exponent variable is y here, and exponent of y is 3. So 3 is the degree of this first term, which is 5y cube. Let us look at the second term. It is plus 2y square. What is the exponent of the variable? Variable is y, and its exponent is 2. Exponent is power, raised to the power. So exponent is 2, so degree of second term is 2. Now let us look at the third one. Variable. Variables are x and y. Now two variables are there. So in this case, we will add the two exponents. So 1 plus 1 is 2. Suppose I had another term. X y square. What is the degree of this particular term? X power is 1, y power is 2, so 1 plus 2 is 3. So that is the degree of this term. Is this clear? Now coming to degree of a polynomial. So degree of a polynomial is same as the degree of its term or terms having the highest degree and non-zero coefficient. So whatever term is given to you, if the term given is, say, t raised to the power 10 plus 5t raised to the power 5 plus 1. So what is the degree of the polynomial? Highest degree. You have to look at the degree of each term. Degree of first term is 10. Degree of second term is 5. And what is the degree of the third term? Only 1 is here. So we can write it t raised to the power 0. Because t raised to the power 0 is 1. So degree of third term is 0. So any constant will be there. We can always put the variable there with power 0. So degree of third term here is 0. But we are talking of degree of the polynomial. So you have to look at the highest degree. You have to look at that term which has got the highest degree. So highest degree is 10 here. So this is the degree of the polynomial. Now let us apply this knowledge in solving this question. Rewrite the polynomials in increasing order of their degrees. First, we need to write down the degree for each one of them. degree of first one power is 6, degree of second one, sorry, I shouldn't be writing x here, degree is 2. Degree is 2 here. What about third one? 9x. 9x means power is 1. So degree is 1 here. What about the fourth one? Power 3. So degree is 3 here. It's a constant, last one. So if it is a constant, it can be written as x raised to the power 0 here. So what is the degree? Degree is 0. So rewrite the given polynomials in increasing order of their degrees. So increasing order. Let's first write down the numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3 and 6. So 0. 0 is 2.5. Degree 1 is 9x. Degree 2 is 2 by 9x square. Degree 3 is minus 25x cube. And degree 6 is minus 3x raised to the power 6. So this is the increasing order. I hope it is clear. In this question, we have to determine the degree of the given polynomials. So let's see, degree of this term 6 plus 4 is 10. When we have got two variables or more than two variables, we are going to add the exponents. So 6 plus 4 is 10. Now look at the second question. We cannot consider 10 raised to the power 5. 10 raised to the power 5 is constant. We have to see the powers of the variables. If you see this, it is actually 10 raised to the power 5. That is a constant. So what is the degree? Degree will be 1 plus 3, that is 4. In third part, we have to find the degree of each term. Let us first look at the degree of each term. Degree of x square y is 2 plus 1, that is 3. Degree of x y square is 1 plus 2, that is also 3. Degree of minus 3 x y is 1 plus 1, that is 2. Nothing is here, so what is the degree? It is 0, because we can write x raised to 0 out here. So what is the degree of this particular polynomial? Highest degree is 3. So that will be the degree of the given polynomial. Next, we will understand what are linear, quadratic and cubic polynomials. A polynomial of degree 1 is called a linear polynomial. So if I write down 2x plus 1, what is the degree? Degree is 1, so it is a linear polynomial. If I write down x plus y, degree is 1, it is a linear polynomial. A polynomial of degree 2 is called a quadratic polynomial. If I write down x square plus 2, what is the degree here? Degree is 2. Y square plus 3y plus 1. This polynomial has got 3 terms. But what is the degree of the polynomial? Degree is 2. So it is a quadratic polynomial. A polynomial of degree 3 is called a cubic polynomial. So if we have something like 3 z cube plus 2z square plus z plus 5. Number of terms are 4 out here. Variable is z here. And what is the degree of the polynomial? Degree of the polynomial is 3. So it is a cubic polynomial. It could be something like this also. X cube plus 1. Degree is 3 here. So the number of terms are only 2. It is a cubic polynomial. Our question is, classify the following polynomials as linear, quadratic and cubic. Now we'll find the degree in each case. Let us write down the degree of the given polynomial in each case. Degree, highest power is 2, so degree is 2. In second one, highest value of exponent is 3, so degree is 3. In third one, highest value of exponent is 2, degree is 2. Fourth one, 8 plus z, so it is actually z raised to the power 1. So degree is 1. 8r, so it is r raised to the power 1, degree is 1. T square, degree is 2. 10x cube, power of x is 3, so degree is 3. So now let us classify the polynomial. Degree 2. First let us look at linear. So degree has to be 1. So this one is linear, degree 1. This is also linear. Degree 2, quadratic. And degree 3 is cubic. So we have to just find the degree of the polynomial and accordingly classify them as linear, quadratic and cubic. We will now be talking of value of a polynomial. So this is a polynomial given 5x cube minus 2x square plus 3x minus 1. And you can write it like this, px, because this polynomial, I'm denoting polynomial by p, and this polynomial is having variable x. So it can be denoted as px is equal to 5x cube minus 2x square plus 3x minus 1. Now we have to find the value of the polynomial at 1 and at 2. So value of the polynomial at 1 is, what does it mean? It means that if x is equal to 1, what will be the value of this polynomial? So instead of x, we can write 1 out here and put the values. We'll put the value of x 1 everywhere in each term. See, what do you get? It is 1 cube is 1 only, 1 square is 1 only, 3 multiplied by 1, 1. Solve it further. It will be 5 minus 2 plus 3 minus 1. So this comes out to be 5. So value of the given polynomial at x is equal to 1 is 5. Now find the value of the polynomial at x is equal to 2. So we denote it by P2. So put the value of x as 2. Solve it. 2 cube 8, 2 square 4, 3 into 2 is 6, minus 1. It is 40, 5 8s are 40, 2 4s are 8, plus 6, minus 1. Solve it. 46 minus 9. So this is 37. So value of the given polynomial at x is equal to 2 is 37. Another question is given out here. Evaluate the polynomial. This is the given polynomial. So we can denote it like px is equal to x square plus 3x minus 5. And you have to find its value at minus 2. So instead of x, put minus 2. So this is 4 minus 6 minus 5. So minus 7 is the value of the given polynomial at x is equal to minus 2. The last topic that we will be taking today is zero of a polynomial. So the value of the variable for which the value of a polynomial in one variable is zero is called zero of the polynomial. For example, let me take you are given a polynomial x minus 1. So for what value of x will this polynomial become 0? That means if this polynomial I denote by px, for what value of x will it become 0? It's quite simple. If I put x as 1, it will become 0. So what will we say? We will say 1 is a 0 of the polynomial x minus 1. So for whatever value of the variable, the given polynomial becomes 0. The value of the given polynomial becomes 0. So that value is called zero of the polynomial. I'll take another example. The given polynomial is 2x minus 3. Now for what value of x will this polynomial, that is 2x minus 3, become 0? What we can do, if you look at it in the corner, you can solve it. You have to make it equal to 0. So x is coming 3 by 2. Now let us try here. We will put the value of x as 3 by 2. If we put the value of x as 3 by 2, what is the value of the polynomial? 2 and 2 gets cancelled. We are left with 3 minus 3, which is 0. So we can say that 3 by 2 is a 0 of the polynomial 2x minus 3. In this particular question, we have to verify whether the following are zeros of the polynomial and values are indicated again against each question. Px is equal to 3x square minus 1 and x is given to us as minus 1 by root 3. So let us find. We will put the value of x as minus 1 by root 3 and try to solve it. Square of minus will be a positive term and root 3 square is 3 minus 1. 3 and 3 gets cancelled. 1 minus 1 is 0. So we get 0. So we will say x is equal to minus 1 by root 3 is a 0 of the given polynomial. Let us try 2 by root 3. Put the value of x as 2 by root 3. Solve it. It is 4 upon 3 minus 1. 3, 3 gets cancelled. 4 minus 1 is 3. So we are not getting the answer 0 here. So 2 upon root 3 is not a 0 of the given polynomial. Let us look at this question. We are given Px is equal to Lx plus m. Now this L and m are constants in this question. And we have to put the value of x as m upon L. So instead of x, we will put m upon L. L and L gets cancelled. M plus m is equal to 2m. So x is equal to m upon L is not a 0 of the given polynomial. Had the same question been Px is equal to Lx minus m, in that case x is equal to m upon L would have been the 0 of the given polynomial. You can check it also, because here it will come at the end then m minus m. So m minus m is equal to 0. In this case it would have been a 0 of the polynomial, but for Lx plus m, x is equal to m by L is not a 0 of the given polynomial. Let's quickly find the 0 of the given polynomial. Now here by looking at this only you can say, now how do we find whether it is 0 of the polynomial or not? In first part it is simple, by looking at it only you can say 7 minus 7 is 0. So how do we find the 0 of the polynomial? We'll put it equal to 0. 7 minus x minus 7 is equal to 0. So this implies x is equal to 7. So find the 0 of the polynomial in each case. So in first one, 0 of the polynomial is 7. Now in second case, put 2x minus 5 equal to 0. Solve it. 2x is equal to 0 plus 5. 2x is equal to 5. And x is equal to 5 by 2. So x is equal to 5 by 2 is a 0 of the given polynomial. You can put the value also 2 multiplied by 5 by 2. 2, 2 gets cancelled. Only 5 is left. 5 minus 5 is 0. Same way in the third part, cx plus d. C and d are constants here. And it is given that c is not equal to 0. So equate it to 0. Cx is equal to 0 minus d. Cx is equal to minus d. X is equal to minus d by c. So x is equal to minus d by c is a zero of the given polynomial, and you are already given that c is not zero. Had c been zero, then minus d upon c could have indefinite value also. We cannot have zero in the denominator. So, dear children, the home assignment for today is given here. There are 5 questions in all. Please try these questions, and in the next part we will discuss these questions before taking up further questions. That's all for today. Om Sai Ram.